I'm going to show you how to add a layer of mist to your ArcGIS Online web map. You've definitely seen me do this in ArcGIS Pro, but online? Here I am in the ArcGIS Online map viewer, and I'm going to add a layer here from Living Atlas, and I'm going to look for elevation. And right here, terrain, that's what I want. Add this. This is an image service from Living Atlas. It covers the whole world at every scale, and it's a digital elevation model. Darker areas are lower elevation, lighter areas are higher elevation. But you might not realize that you aren't stuck with this color scheme here in ArcGIS Online. With the Style tab open, I can dig into this. And for my stretch type, I've got minimum maximum set, and I'm gonna pick dynamic range. That means it only considers the lowest and highest values within my view. It squeezes the color gradient, so you always force the full contrast of black to white to within the map view. Now we want mist, and mist happens at lower elevations. So I'm gonna open this color scheme, edit it, and I'm just gonna invert it. And it looks pretty trippy this way. But how can we see through to the higher elevations, which are now grays and blacks? We'll use a blend mode. In the Properties tab, instead of a normal blend mode, choose Screen. Screen only considers the lightness of pixels and ignores pixels that are darker. Oh my goodness, immediately we have this beautiful sense of mist cloaking the valleys and river channels and low elevation areas in our view. And there are a few handles that we can play with if you want to tweak this effect. Transparency can control the strength of the effect, but if we go back to the Styles tab, into the options, we can use gamma to effectively raise and lower the mist effect. Raising the gamma lowers the mist. Lowering the gamma fills up our map with higher and higher levels of mist. Gamma. And because we're using the terrain image service from Living Atlas, it re-renders at all scales and areas. And because we have dynamic range turned on, it'll always peg white to the lowest elevation in our map, so it'll always look pretty good. But it's not a tiled layer. So as you navigate, the whole scene is fetched and not individual tiles. So it's not as performant as if it were tiled. There's a little bit of waiting involved, but it's worth it. I found that adding a mist layer like this tells an enormous amount of information about the terrain of a place, its general slope, its regional textures, it helps to highlight river valleys and mountain tops, and in general has a weird sort of emotional buzz to it that I just love.